So, what if somebody were to say Jesus is our substitute, he takes our guilt, but then he's pardoned as well? So then it seems like God doesn't need to punish anybody, but he's also taken our guilt away because Jesus bore it and then was pardoned.
Well, my interest, Mike, is in enunciating not only a philosophically coherent, but a biblical theory of the atonement. And it's clear, I think, in the New Testament that Jesus is punished for our sins, not just pardoned for them, that our sins are imputed to Christ. He who knew no sin was made to be sin for us, Paul says in 2 Corinthians 5:17. And then he bears our sins. He bears the just desert that our sins carry. So I don't think we should think of God's pardoning Jesus as opposed to exercising punishment.
Does that have more of like an expressive function as to why he wouldn't have been
pardoned? Well, no, I think what it does is it satisfies the demands of divine justice.
So he couldn't have been pardoned?
If we think, as the speaker previously in the previous session suggested, if we think of retributive justice as essential to the nature of God, then this will satisfy the demands of God's justice that would be intrinsic to his very nature. And so retributive punishment of our sins in Christ would satisfy that justice.
Okay, so it would have been unjust for God to pardon Jesus then?
Well, I'd have to think about that some more. Okay. What I suspect that that wouldn't satisfy the demands of retributive justice, but even if it didn't or did, it wouldn't be a biblical theory.
Sure, no, I agree with that.
And that's the key thing.
Sure, right.